Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. Now, today, we could do Isaac, but I feel like I've been leaving my main man out, Samson. If you didn't know, Samson is my favorite character, so we're going to try to get him to Delirium. We are on a 3-win streak right now, which is amazing. I don't think I've ever counted, like, what type of streak I've been on. I know that I've been on a very large losing streak, but that was at the beginning of this series. Now we've stepped it up. We've stepped it up, and now we are at a good winning streak. It's called a losing streak, but, you know, technically it's a negative winning streak. Oh, please. Woo! See that? Seize the opportunities, gentlemen. Please, please. Oh, you son of a bitch. He pushed me back into them. I was trying to escape. He saw, and he seized the opportunity. You know, just like I said, he seized the opportunity. We're going to take this. Oh, look at this room. I wish I could see my map, but I can't because we have this stupid curse. So we are going to go back into that curse room because that chest could have something important in it. It could be a teleport to a devil deal. It could be a guppy item, it could be soul hearts, it could be anything that's very important to us. Also, I need to remember that this isn't a challenge and that we need to find our item room. And I completely forgot about finding the item room until just now. So. And also, I need to mute my phone. Okay. So the dumb damage has kind of been at a high right now, but... you know, when you're Samson... Dumb damage kind of is helpful, I guess. Hell no. It's kind of helpful because it adds to your damage. It's like we're Bergamo for Dragon Ball Super. You know, the more he takes damage, he takes their damage and multiplies it, or he puts it in his fist and then he hits them back with it, and he also gets bigger. But that's also a fault because then he has a lot more blind spots. But, you know, it's worth if you're trying to get rid of opponent very quickly. You're like, hey, dude, why don't you beat me up a little bit like you did with Goku. But his Bergamo's deal is that he's not as smart as Goku. Or he underestimated how smart Goku was. Also, I'd like to point out that we have officially hit 400 hours on the Binding of Isaac Rebirth, which is good. Which is really good. I like it. That's probably about 100, or not 100, probably around like, actually, yeah, probably like somewhere near 100 of those hours have been in Afterbirth Plus. And because I remember I stopped playing Afterbirth Plus, or as I stopped playing Afterbirth or The Binding of Isaac in general, around like 293 hours. You know, I was super excited about getting to 300 hours in this game, and then I just stopped playing it. I don't know if something else came out or if I just stopped playing games altogether. Not altogether, because, you know, I always play games. It's like, you know, it's been my hobby ever since I was a little kid. You know, I feel like, generally, if you play video games as an adult, it's probably because it was one of your hobbies as a youngin'. So we didn't find any bombs like I wanted to, so we couldn't go back to that room. Another Curse of the Lost, please. You're gonna stop this. Also, sorry about that. My controller was doing the glitch. This room is not gonna be nice to me, I can tell you right now. I almost made it through. It's okay, though, because now we can... we've been able to kill these guys with two shots from the beginning, but now it's, like, super reinforced. I'm not sure if these spiders take 17 damage to kill like the double ones, but you know what, I'll find out now. Let's get our Mythbusters on. Come here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, it takes 5 shots. Actually, I was incorrect, so it's not double, it's like, what the hell. Mom's toenail. What did it do? I don't think it killed anything, dude. This fucking room, these stupid spiders, they move so sporadically. Thank you. Oh, here's our bomb. Now, you know, after like fucking 50 years, we finally get a bomb. But we needed it on the last floor. So if you couldn't tell, our main goal this run is to make it to Delirium, because we need that fresh blood stain on the edge of our post-it. We just finished Eden as well, so his post-it is nice and fresh as well. His, her, you know, Eden. I don't think Eden has a gender. You know what? We're just gonna put a little nice little bomb right there. Swallow Penny would be good if we were the keeper. I was actually really excited to see that, and then I remembered we weren't the keeper. We'll go back to the keeper one day. One day we will. One day he'll be remembered. I'm not sure if we should keep Mom's Toenail or Swallowed Penny. I feel like Mom's Toenail, her foot doesn't come down very often. Okay, we got a key, which is good. So now we can get into our item room or our shop, depending on if we get a key from this room as well. Or, you know, just depending on how I feel, because, you know, there's a chance that there could be a key in here that I wanted, and there's also like another item. This could also be a lucky shop. You know, it all depends on how you look at it and how your expectations are. You can go in there and be disappointed, or you can go in there and be excited because you were correct in thinking the way you did. Now, so far we've been playing this game blind. I, you know, maybe Samson has, like, you know, his headband is like over his eyes or something, and that's what's going on. Okay, so we can go back to the shop, but I'll do that later. Okay, of course. We'll just let those guys, you know, go on with their day, do their job. Why do they... Dude, these flies move so fucking weird, I swear. They, like, swing around. Come in here. Doctor's remote? Yeah, doctor's remote. Oh, Dr. Fetus. I was like, why is this called doctor's remote? I thought this was a teleport. Actually, let's do this. Fucking troll bomb. Cut this out. So we have been moving, I mean, like, in the past, we've moved this slow through a run, and we've made it to Delirium and Boss Rush and Hush in the end, so I'm not too worried right now, but I feel like, there's something inside of me that's going, and you should probably be a little worried right now. But, I'm not gonna listen to him. Oh, I've taken damage here, we're not gonna get a double deal. Okay, so, actually, I'll take a look at this, too. Hagalos is probably better. I could've used Hagalos instead of a doctor's remote to open up that... the tinted rock. Fuck. Now I have to remember where we haven't been. We're moving really slow right now. You know, but like I said, we have been moving this slow before. Like, I remember we were moving super slow on the one daily, and then now look at that daily. We got like 200 and something place. I was watching Northern Lion play it, and I was like, haha, beat that guy, and then he got like 139th place. So. So he did beat that. And I was very disappointed. That's gonna be a red heart. And this isn't the boss room somehow. What is this, a fucking XL floor? Shit. I mean, obviously it's not an XL floor because it can't be. Because, you know, this is the second floor of the first chapter. Can you cut this out? Can you stop? How are you making babies right now? Like, you look like a baby. Can you take... Oh, I didn't know that you didn't take contact damage from guts. Learn something new every day. How is there still more to this floor? Please don't. They trapped me in, dude. Did the triangular formation. Yeah, cut that out. What? We're just gonna do this. You guys gotta go. I honestly didn't think that would hit me. Tears up. Good, good, good. That's really good, actually. And we're still... Come on, where's the boss room? Thank you, dude. I'm starting to get a little aggravating, actually. Secret room? Ah. Probably could have killed Nahant if I was just a little bit more patient in that room. Or just, you know, one-shot Nahant if I was more patient in that room and I didn't use our doctor's remote. But we have good damage, so we should be able to get through this fight fairly quickly. Not too quick, because, you know, we still gotta hit him, and we can't aim, I guess, today. Now we can aim. Look at this. I knew it. I know he's gonna do that. Alright, dope. Please. And we still got the devil deal somehow. And it's not really what we wanted, but... Something. We did get something out of it. We got a soul heart. And then we got some friends, but they're gonna die soon. I would say that Curse of the Lost was the reason why we were moving so slow. Maybe I'll come back to that curse room if we get some... if we can find some soul hearts, because I don't want to just have half of an insurance heart, because then we'll definitely lose our devil deal. But at this point, there's also a chance that it could be an angel gift instead of a devil deal. And the angel gifts are normally kind of shitty. So hopefully we still get a devil deal. We beat the odds, and we're moving a lot faster. I was asking for speed, so that's pretty cool. Cut it out. Stop this. Okay. All right. Oh, dude, fuck this room. Fuck these enemies. It's bonies. Bonies in general. Just fuck them. Why are you? Oh my. Oh my god, that was terrible. You know what? Let's use this. See what we get. Didn't get a magic mushroom, I'm assuming. Yep. I didn't want to just be carrying the fucking Hagalaws like throughout the entire game. I'm drowsy. It's really good, actually. I'm glad I picked that up, because now these guys are gonna be a piece of cake to kill. Can you? Oh my god! Please, brain. And oh my god! What, dude? Three floors with no mapping. This is ridiculous. Stop. Okay. I can't hit anything. This is actually going pretty not well. And you know, if we can't make it to Delirium, then we'll just go to the chest and do a regular run, I guess. I mean, hopefully we don't die. But at this point, I would assume that we wouldn't die. But we are taking a long time. I mean, we don't need to finish the entire floor, especially since this isn't a daily. So maybe we can kind of cut some corners. Hopefully we can find a luck up. Okay. It's not what I was hoping we could find. I was saying hopefully we could find a our item room and our boss room relatively close to each other, and then maybe we could speed through the next floor. I was moved a little too fast there. Not, don't do this. We have Curse of the Maze and Curse of the Blind. Please, God, why? What have I done? Good, alright, so we got rid of that pretty quickly. Now, these bomb flies don't scare me, but there have been times where I've taken stupid damage from those. Infestation 2 is going to be really good. It's not exactly what I wanted. It's a good item. I give this item like a B-tier item. I mean, I place it in the B-tier. Please die. Yeah, I'd place these enemies in the shit tier. The mushrooms? Yeah, these are garbage tier enemies. I'm gonna be a little risky and put a bomb right here. Hopefully get magic mushroom. No, okay, we didn't get anything that I wanted right there. You know, at least these enemies don't take forever to kill. What we need is damage. Do you see the items that we have? Not very good. I mean, Infestation 2 is good, but we're not killing enemies fast enough to the point where Infestation 2 is really good. What is this? Range up, okay. And it sent us back. I'm begging you to put our fucking boss or somewhere around here. I'm glad that none of those were grandfather fly, because that would have, they definitely would have hit me up, shot me up. Okay. Just like that right there. Now, unless we can find Mama Mega in a shop on like the depths too, I don't think we're making it to boss rush. But honestly, boss rush shouldn't be what I'm too worried about. What I should be worried about is Hush. Because if I can fight Hush and beat him, that's 1% guarantee that we don't go underground. Thank you. That didn't do as much damage as I thought it would. I thought it would have, like, one-shot him. Oh, you motherfucker. Oh, they're fucking devil deal. Dude, what is... Very disappointed with what just happened right there. You know, at first, you know, I was taking the damage, it was cute. It was a cutesy. It was like, this is damage. Oh, of course, baby's first damage. And then I took like three hits in a row for no fucking reason. So I just can't get a break with these curses. That damage right there is just extremely dumb. Friends till the end. I'm not sure how much health I have. I know I don't have any soul hearts, and I'm sure I have some empty red heart container. So should be on the lookout for not taking damage. We've really been, like, we've been starved of damage this run. Like, the only way we can get damage is from taking dumb damage. See, this is why I place Infestation 2 in the B tier. Because if you can kill enemies fast enough, like, before your spiders get to them and fucking kamikaze, then you're good. But if you can't kill them fast enough, then you have, like, one-time use spiders. Also, we took some more dumb damage. I'm really bummed out right now, if you can't tell. But you know what? I can't, like, get in my own head, you know? I mean, I am in my own head. But, I'm saying in a way that, like, I get in my own head and I'm like, oh, you're a stupid idiot. You know, you make dumb decisions. Why do you even play this game? Like, you know, it's thoughts like that. So we need to find our item room. Like, mapping makes me just feel so much better. Like, the fact that I can see where we're going is fantastic. Alright, good. You know what? You guys gotta go. I don't like you. Fuck it. You know, we'll just fight the boss normally. Gimpy is good, but I don't think... I need, like, damage right now. I'm going for damage. Blank card. Please. How did I know it was gonna be that one next? Like, what are the chances that you get the two... Dude. Okay, two of diamonds is alright, I guess. I guess now we should look for our shop. Are you kidding me? Why did I even try to go up? I have no idea how much health I have, and I'm sure I'm on the verge of death right now. Stop this. You know, I'm just gonna assume that I have like half a heart left. Please come over here. Stop him, spiders. Thank you. My spider babies. Hierophant. Judgment. I was afraid that that was going to be like a demon beggar, and it was going to kill me. It was going to steal my last heart. Thank you. I was actually hoping for some type of health. But I need a shop. Oh. Ooh, okay. Okay, good. We're getting health back, so we're not on half a health. Half a heart. You know, I'm not thinking that we're gonna make it a hush or we're gonna make it to the void or not. Like, oh my god, for real? Watch, he's gonna survive this. Look, do you see that? He survived a fucking missile, dude. He survived an epic fetus shot. Like, why? And he's still going. It took me, like, two more opening closes to kill him. God, how much health do they give those guys? No, I'm surrounded on all sides. Okay. Oh god, except from behind. Okay. Ugh. No, we're lucky that we have range, because that room would have ended very differently if we didn't. Not gonna take compost. I feel like in the past I've given that item way too much credit. Maybe I should donate. Until I can't donate no mo. Why did our angel gift chances go up so much, man? Our angel gift chance went up like 25%. There's no way we're getting a devil deal now. I mean, we're probably not even going to get a deal in the first place because our deal chance is 18%. Unless I'm reading that incorrectly. The way I read it is that the upside down cross is like your chance of getting a devil deal or an angel gift. And then the cross that's, you know, facing the correct way is your chance of getting an angel gift rather than a devil deal. But that I could be wrong. Oh, please. No, come here. Oh, you bitch. Come here. Yeah, eat that shit. So you're trying to eat something so bad. More. Oh my god. We're definitely not going to the void. This it's not happening. The void is it's a fever dream right now. I'm really glad that our spiders took that guy out. Look, dude, our Infestation 2 is our best item right now. Oh, okay. And we have half an insurance heart, so if we can... You know what? Let's just clear that out right there. Just get rid of that. Please die. Thanks a lot. You'll excuse me just a second. I was muting my phone. Sorry about that. Hierophant, good. So we have extra hearts. If only we had tarot cloth. And why are there hush flies in here, man. And that guy is gonna, like, either he's gonna give me, like, a soul heart when he dies, or he's gonna shoot out, like, a million tears, and I don't want to be near him to find out when it happens. But, you know, first these guys have to die. So, you know, let's just put that right there and then run away. He's still alive. He's still alive. That was a slick move by yours truly, and he... Are you fucking kidding me? I hate... No, okay. Empress. At least it's health. I mean, we were close. Let's just say fuck that. And I still took damage. maybe this is the game saying, alright, you've done enough. And more. Okay, at least they jump on spikes, you know? Like, at least they're stupid. They're like, alright, we gotta compensate for the player somehow. Boop. Bye bye. Let's come in here and take that. If we had 9 volt, we could use this literally every room. Stay right there. Okay. The one that had the blood running down his face, he likes to jump, so I had to take him out first. Golden bombs is gonna be good if we can find, you know, a room in which oh god. Okay, if we can find a room in which it's useful to use them. Ooh, okay. Alright. Where are our item rooms, man? Item rooms, like, holy shit. Boss rooms, we haven't found it either. You know, I'm fine with exploring. Yeah, we'll take that. We will definitely take that. It's not worth. That one splits into two. Why did he split into this guy? He's not a greed head. Why, dude? They just did this to piss me off. And you know what? It's working, dude. I'm kind of running off the rails right now in terms of mood, but you know what? I shouldn't be. Everything's good. It's all good in the hood. So you know what? I'm just gonna chill. I'm just gonna assess this run right now. So we're not gonna make it to boss rush, and we're probably not gonna make it to hush. You know, this hasn't been like a huge run, but it's been exceptional. You know, like, it's not like this run is, it's testing our skills, I should say. And, boy, is it doing a good job of doing that, because I feel worn out. I definitely feel tested on, you know. And I'm hoping that this doesn't take forever. I mean, if there's a possibility that, that we can fight Delirium and get, you know, Samson over with, even though Samson's my boy, we have bigger fish to fry, you know. And if I can finish this up, I'll definitely try my best to do that. But I don't want to lose the streak that we have going right now. So if I don't think, if I can't use my better judgment and, you know, be like, yeah, we can do it, or no, we can't do it, then I'm just not gonna do it. Because right now, if we had to fight Delirium, I'd be like, uh-uh, it's just not happening. Oh, please stop this! Look, these guys don't die. Why did they just make everything tanky in this, like, in this DLC? Like, I paid money for this. I paid good money for this, and they just made everything, like, they just gave everything, like, 1,000 extra health. It's ridiculous. And you know what? I haven't been focusing one more than the other, but I definitely haven't been, like, shooting them, like, equal amounts. Can you die? Of course not. Yeah, I'll take the Hanged Man. I don't even remember what that other card was. This is terrible, though. You know, this is probably a good room to use this in. Okay. And now I can get around the creep. What? God. Okay, but could you imagine how much more damage I would have taken if I didn't have that card? And I should go back for the other card, whatever it was. I think it was the Empress, which gives you Horror of Babylon. Dude. What is going on? How XL is this XL floor? Like, it's huge. Well, there's our Tinted Rock. I haven't found one of those in a while. Wouldn't it be funny if we accidentally shot the bomb? I mean, it wouldn't have mattered because we have golden bombs, but still, that would have been like a little icing on the cake from yours truly. Boop. Okay. That was a little risky thing I did there, but you know what? It paid out. I mean, it would have paid out either way if I had been patient. What the f... Okay. You know, I don't know why I'm so bummed out. Taking damage here really doesn't matter. I mean, you know, it does matter. Because, you know, I could lose my angel gift or my devil deal chance, but... Like, I'm cornering myself. Do you fucking see this? You see that? That was a coordinated attack. From my fucking PC, dude. Okay, 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 okay. Let's open this up. Blood bag. Could be really good as Samson. Like, it'll up our damage. I'm sure it doesn't get rid of your devil deal chance, though. Please, thank you. That room was miserable. Let's see what's in here. It's good that these guys are really easy to avoid. Yes, I'll take that. And now I won't take that. where are... Look, alright, come on. You gotta agree with me. Like, there's something fishy going on, because we should have definitely found something by now. Here's how we do this. Look at that, alright. So now we gotta hope for soul hearts. So we're just gonna sit here and read these fortunes, get these cards, get these trinkets, get these soul hearts, hopefully. But you know that these never pay out, especially when you have 5 luck. These are supposed to go off of luck, right? Okay. I mean, I guess we did get soul hearts, so that's good. And yes, that was the Empress, so I was correct. Dude, this... How big is this floor? This floor is, like, overly huge. Like, I didn't think, coming onto this floor, that I would be, like, I would have gone the absolute last direction. Or, you know, the right direction was the absolute last way I would have gone. 6 luck... Look, dude, we need tough love. We need tough love. That would make this run... So much more better. I would pick this run up from its bootstraps and go, alright, soldier, get up. Stop being a pussy. You know? It's like there was an explosion right next to us, and our run is like a private. And he was like knocked out from the explosion. And it's kind of shell shocked, but not really. And you know, the seasoned veteran walked up to him and was like, get up, bitch. And he picked him up. By his shirt collar, and pushed them away, and then they kept moving. You know, I'm sure that wouldn't actually happen on a battlefield, but sure, faith reward. I don't know if this does anything besides give you another version of you. But you know, definitely after we finish this floor, he's not gonna be helping out very much. I can tell you that. Stigmata. Okay, it's a little bit of extra damage. I'm pretty sure that's our first damage item. I don't know why we got 1.16 damage. I feel like it never gives you that much. And we still haven't found our boss rooms. I honestly can't believe this. Like, they have to be over here. If I take damage from this room, I'm going to be so upset. And then, all right. There's a battery in there, but I mean, like, who cares right now? Open this up. Nothing in here that I want besides this guy. So then we'll donate some more because we've been neglecting our donation machine, and finally it stopped letting us pay out. Stay there. Thanks a lot. Does Doctor's Remote go off of or scale with your damage, or is that because the sisters' vis don't have much health in the first place? Don't you stare? Yeah, stay there. It kind of sounded like I said don't you stare, but that's not what I meant. I meant to say don't you dare. I mean, I guess she was staring at me because her eye was poking through the door. And unfortunately, there wasn't a Mama Mega in there, and we got a devil deal over a freaking What is it? Angel gift. All right. So finally, we got some. Look at this. All right. So now we're in business. We don't have 12 damage because you know that's from Bloody Lust, but we do have 4.9. I thought we would at least have like 5, and I guess this is kind of 5, but you know this isn't the 5 that I want. Like, I want to see like the actual number 5. I don't want to see a freaking 4.9. I don't want to have to round up. Friends till the end. That's good. So, I guess at this point, maybe Infestation 2 will start to pay out a little bit more. If we become Guppy, I'll definitely go down to the Void if we get the chance to. But if we don't become Guppy, I mean, Okay, well, the spiders kind of made me like they made that useless basically, the doctor's remote. You see, and it's rooms like this where like if you have like if I used like if I took compost with me and then I came all the way down here and then like I built up like an army of spiders and they were just fucking things up, that room would have killed them all because they would have attacked the host either way, like even if it was up or down. Please. All right. Oh, you motherfuck. I knew that's what it did, and for some reason in my head it didn't click. And we take whole hearts of damage down here, so we're definitely not going into the curse room unless we have some type of we get some type of repayment. But you know, we can't even know that for sure. Please. Okay, good. Stay above ground, please. Thanks a lot. All right. Let me in. Thank you. No, we have max tier delay. And our damage is not good enough as it is. So you know what? This run has been very mediocre. It's not a lot of interesting things going on besides our tier delay. And I'm speaking in terms of like item wise. Damage wise, I mean, yeah, we've taken a lot of damage. This run has been very interesting in that sense, especially when we were fighting the stain back there on the second floor of the basement. Okay. Stop, you stay away from me. I'm touching boy. You know, I'm really lucky that that thing was there to block the leech from coming at me. Oh, please stop. Dude, I fucking hate these guys right here, the one that I'm shooting at right now. Not the walking host, they aren't that much of a problem, but these guys, they shoot a triple tier at you that you have to dodge, and then they disappear instantly. Like they're just annoying. Ooh, no. How is this fair? How is that fair, dude? This room needs to be nerfed or something. How are you supposed to dodge that? Oh, so I feel like all the health that we gained is gone. Because if you walk in there and there's a guy sitting right next to you, like there was for me, I mean, I guess the only way to like a safe way to avoid this room is to just not walk into small rooms if you have the chance to. Hierophant, please. You gotta go. Hierophant, Emperor. You know what? Yeah, we'll do that. Mr. Fred is very easy. Hopefully his little friends here don't get off the chain. Can you come back up? Oh my, he knew. Also, that one was stuck there for a long ass time, and I'm now realizing that we can just stand here and do this. Since you wanna go away when we're shooting our rocket at you. This is your punishment, dude. You can't even hit me. I can hit you though. So in terms of items, what could we possibly want? I mean, besides everything. Look at this room, it's lovely. Isn't it lovely? Isn't this room wonderful? I have no idea how much health we have. I'm just gonna play risky. I'll buy this, and then I'll buy this. And then I'll take Abaddon because it gives us damage and it also gives us a ton of Sin Hearts. So there's no way that we don't have like at least 6 health right now. Let's see. Yeah, okay. Look at all that health, boy. I wish we could have had some. Okay, please stop. Okay, I wish we could have had or we could have gotten some Gubby items in there. That was a really good room, though. I feel like that kind of. You see, that was the. That run or that room was the dickhead soldier, not the dickhead soldier, the seasoned veteran that picked our run up by its bootstraps and was like, "Come on, soldier, let's go." That one, or by his collar, not his bootstraps. You know, apparently, oh, I read on Reddit that the pick yourself up by your bootstraps was supposed to be like it was supposed to like tell you that what you're trying to do is impossible and you shouldn't try to do it, or and you should I don't know. Basically, it meant what you're trying to do is impossible, or that's at least part of it. And we have turned pull your belt pull yourself up from your bootstraps into something similar to like pick yourself up. You know, like just like you know pack up, not pack up, but like get up from where you were and try again. Basically, when that's not the that wasn't the meaning of the quote in the first place. You know, now I was complaining about not having enough damage, but this is great now. Like, honestly, I feel like I'd go down to the void with this build. I don't know, like, I'd go down to the void and hope that we found some really good items that would carry us while we were down there. But if I didn't find any good items, then I'd be extremely worried at the Delirium play. That's the kind of build that we have right now. And it's not bad. It's not bad, you know, like I said, I'd be worried, but maybe we'd be able to do it. Like, if our Deadeye, like, kind of carried us, then maybe this would go well. So we're not gonna play that because there's no red health anywhere, and I don't want to give up our Sin Hearts. Our Sin Hearts are kind of the MVPs right now. Not the MVPs, but they're definitely protecting us from taking stupid damage. Or, well, I guess I should say they're protecting us from dying a stupid death. Also, no mapping again. Ooh. This, I haven't had much maps at all this run. Of course, you know what? Like, this room is kind of messed up. You know, I'm lucky I had the invincibility frames for as long as I did, because I thought I had, you know, I thought the Polaroid popped, but it did not. And I'm glad that the run has given us something to help us. To, you know, to help us out in the real world. It's like we're starting a business. It's like, you know, we were starting a business with this run, and, you know, we were struggling like the whole entire time we were running the business, and then like our father gives us a $1 million loan, and then they're like, there you go. That's what this was right now. And now our father is hoping that either, you know, we take the safe route and we just, you know, put the money to use, or, you know, we take the unsafe route, and when the chance presents itself, we go to the void, and we risk it all. You know, we risk all the money. We know what we could get from risking it all. That's finishing the post-it. But our dad wants us to take the safe route and just go to the chest and beat Blue Baby. But if we do that, then we're not gonna get the post-it. You know, we're not gonna finish Samson. So we have to make the decision on our own. If the decision, you know, like, hands itself to us. Okay. You know, I was kind of thinking about picking up Book of Sin back there, like, just in case we had, so we could become one-third book. That, he actually extended a lot farther than I thought he would. But at least him extending got us a lot more spiders. You know, I don't think him extending really, like, got us all the spiders, because I think they would have spawned either way. Here's a Tinted Rock. But, you know, in my eyes, it got us all the spiders. You know what? The only opinion that matters is mine. So this looks like, yeah, I was gonna say, this looks like where our boss room is probably gonna be. Where are we on the womb one? Oh, we're on the womb two. Good. I would have fought Hush with this build. I'm gonna be 100% honest. And you know what? If the void opens up, I'm going. Ooh, look at that. We're going, boys. There we go. All right. All right. All righty. Please not curse the blind or the lost. Yes, there's no curse. Good. All right. Dope. All right. So our dad is really pissed off at us right now because we're taking the risky route. What? Our dad is really pissed off at us right now because we're taking the risky route. But you know what? God damn it. We're going to do it. We're going to take the risky route. And if we win, we're gonna shove it in Dad's face. We're gonna go, hey, look, dude, this is what you didn't believe in. We're gonna throw all our money at him. So we gotta do our best to prove him wrong. We cannot lose this. Also, if I could find a better spacebar item now, that would be great. I mean, I guess it's my fault for not really using it. But I mean, I haven't really found a really good, like, reason for it. Like, I feel like this item you want to use when there's, like, a ton of enemies, like, just grouped up, and there hasn't really been a situation like that. So we just gotta hope for that situation. If we ever want to, if we ever want to use this item. Now, we're going to use our clear the whole floor and then come back and do the boss's strat. Because I feel like we are kind of lacking item-wise. But, I mean, it's not that bad. Like, Deadeye is kind of carrying us right now. How did we get hit by that little nugget? I don't know, but we didn't. Alright, dope. Also, just a random thought. I really need to update the Binding of Isaac playlist because you know when you schedule, because the way I do it is I don't upload videos and then they magically go up at like I don't upload videos when they should start going up. I upload them like in bulk and then I schedule them for the correct dates. So I can't put them in a playlist. Holy shit. Okay, I can't put them in a playlist. He doesn't get killed by this. That's fake. That's gay. But what? I guess I thought that was one of my own tiers. Okay, so we take whole hearts of damage, so I can't be like, oh, well, we took damage down here, because, you know, this is bad. Also, that spider can hurt me. But anyways, like I was saying, it moved! Alright, we really need... Okay, like, now, like, we're starting to fail a little bit, and our dad is watching us. He's like, like, he's sitting there shaking his head. That's what's going on right now. We can't lose this, alright? We have to prove ourselves in the world. Holy shit, yeah, we must do quite some damage. Oh! I didn't even see that guy. RNG rocks, mom. Stop this. Why does she fucking spawn spiders? We need curved horn for the extra damage. Okay. So we're going to go down, not even going to pay attention to the rosary bead. And we're going to blow up these mushrooms because magic mushroom would be amazing. Like magic mushroom would, if I got magic mushroom, I'd be like, yep, that's the win. That's how confident I am in magic mushroom right now. Hierophant, yes, thank you. And the hermit, so we can go fight bosses. We can fight bosses normally now, but oh, what is this? Pin, please be pin, not Skolex. What's happening here? Oh, it's the Fallen. Hello. It's like this is his lair or something, and we stumbled upon it. Please die. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, get out of here. You know, I just started thinking about something. This is irrelevant to the Binding of Isaac and what we've been doing so far, but I just got accepted into college the other day, and I'm going to this college that's in state, and my girlfriend, she goes to a college that's pretty far away from where I live. It's like a 5-hour drive, and the drive to her school in like two states away from where I live is 5 hours long, and the drive to the school that's in state where I'm trying to go is also 5 hours long. It's kind of ridiculous, you know? Like, I know that there's not like the interstate or something, like maybe the interstate doesn't connect to it or something, but that seems a little ridiculous to me. Like, maybe we need to make a easier, you know, interstate travel. I don't know if that makes sense. I don't know if that makes sense or not. It does to me, at least. I gotta keep hitting him. Oh, and there it goes. Ooh, okay. I was like, oh wait, we're in the wrong spot. Tammy's head. How this could be better than Doctor's Remote. It probably is. Oh, actually, no, it's not. It's not at all. Please don't hurt me. Okay. Ooh, that was close. Hello. Thanks a lot. Okay. I can't get over to that tinted rock, but there is one there. Delirium, bye-bye. Bye-bye, friend. What the... Okay, I forgot. It teleported us somewhere random. No, I really need to hurry up and finish this run, because I have to get ready for work in, like, an hour. So I need to, like, start rendering the daily for today. So that typically takes, like, an hour to 45 minutes. And the daily for today's date was, like... I don't know, I think it was like 30 minutes, so it shouldn't take that long to render. But still, you know, I rush a lot, okay? and I got hit by that, I saw the fly and I was like, okay, I gotta move after I kill it. And it's just, you know, it's amazing how fast we can process things, like with our minds. It's really weird. The brain is a stupid weird organ. Forsaken. This boss gets a bad rep. I feel, what the, stop it. Stop that. Stop doing that shit. Stop it, Delirium. I don't like it. It spooks me out. But it's amazing how fast our brains can process things. And how fast, like, we can react. Because, like, I can walk into a room just holding down my left stick. And then I can look at everything in the room and go, okay, I know exactly what I need to do in order to, complete this room without taking damage, hopefully. And then I can do it. And, you know, most of the time I don't take damage, and it's good, you know, like, I'm successful, and, like, my brain has been successful with how it processed everything that I need to do. And, you know, we don't even think about it, because it's, like, it's second nature, you know? It's crazy. It's 1:53 right now. I need to be at work by... Why did we get Isaac and the Lamb? Can we have, like, our normal boss? I mean, we did just get the Forsaken, but... I mean, he's like a baby. Oh, I forgot to use this as well. He's like a baby boss. Piggy bank. Look, all right. I'm only doing all these bosses because you guys should give me something super good. I don't want you. I was like, why is our damage in the 20s? And then I remembered we have Deadeye. And it's probably a stacked usage of Deadeye. Also, I'm really glad that doesn't stay forever. Come in here. Get you out of here. I wonder how many shots you have to miss in a row for Deadeye to reset. Bam! Mystery sack. We're getting like stupid, like random items. Ooh, that was close. Like, I don't even have to think about where to move my thumb. Like, it just naturally happens. Like, this game is like, I play this game so much that it's like muscle memory to me. Like, muscle memory, that's a weird, it's a weird way to explain how this game works. It's not like my brain remembers like certain ways to dodge specific enemies. But like, it's not like I see an enemy and my brain's like, okay, you gotta move this way and then you move this way. Cause you know, this game, it's randomly generated. So it's not like my brain knows exactly what to do each time. Muscle memory is like remembering a piece of music or like remembering a routine. Like if you play a piece of music long enough, you're not gonna think like, okay, I have to, what? Oh, it was Mystery Sack. Thank you. You're not gonna think like, oh, I have to, you know, put my finger on this specific side of the, or I have to push my finger down on this note, or you know, I have to move my fingers in different positions and, you know, place them there and then blow a specific, like, you know, amount of or pressure of air, and then, you know, that's the note for this thing. Like, you don't have to do that. You don't have to think about that. Like, you just memorize the notes. You know, if you play the instruments long enough. Like, if you're in like sixth grade, then you're probably gonna have to think that, but after a while you don't have to think that anymore. The human body is pretty dope. Also, I don't remember which, I think, yeah, Delirium isn't this one I'm about to head to right now. Delirium is the one like on the right at the bottom, the one I'm walking away from. So this is our last boss. Hopefully he gives us something really OP. Like, I would, if he gave me Serpent's Kiss, I would love him. I would love his boss. Bloat. Oh, never mind. I don't love you. I don't care what you give me. I don't love you, Bloat. You see, look at that. Look at that. We got Small Rock though. That's some nice extra damage right there. It's not too much, but it's not too little. You know, I can appreciate how much it gives to it. Like, I can appreciate how much it gave me, but I understand why it gave me that much. You know, like, it doesn't want to give me enough damage to the point where I can't grow on my own. Like, it'll become a crutch, you know? It respects me enough to the point where it wouldn't just do everything for me. And that's why I like Small Rock. That's why everyone likes Small Rock. All right, Delirium, let's go. I think I can do this. I think I can. Oh God. If I had the wafer, this would be like a done deal. Oh, like, These all these tiers. I need a super easy boss. Like, he needs to turn into, like, a really easy one for me. Oh, what the... Oh, the tier height. They were too high above me. That's why I didn't take damage. That's really good. You know, you can stay low-key. Oh, I don't like that. Those ones explode. Stop this. Where are you at? Oh, pin. Oh, what? Ah. It didn't register in my brain that he was... No, I don't want to die, dude. Okay, maybe I just need to chill. Stop this. Oh my god, okay. I don't know where he's at, I'm just shooting right now. What's happening? Wait, he's about to die? He's the glitch. Oh, I better say the glitch, help me out again. Oh, stop this. What is happening? Okay, he's pinned. You're gonna stomp or what? Fucking spread. Fred spawned on me. Oh, I hate this. He's gonna turn the whole room dark. Okay, good. See, kids, this is what happens when you focus. Alright. Oh, yes, you know, spawn some ads for me so I can get some spider help. Okay. Oh, you... Oh, I didn't take damage? There I did, but... A second ago, I didn't. Stop this. Oh my god. Oof, oof. How didn't I take damage? Is it because of my flies? Yo, flies. Flies MVP. We did it. How? Dude, he had so much health left. Oh my god. And there's another character down, dude. Oh, look at this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What? We haven't beat Delirium as Eden? Wait, have you beat? Did we beat Ultra Greedier as Eden already? Before we did that last run? I don't know. Oh, dude. Okay. I stopped counting. Alright, so there's another character completely finished. Boy, I have recorded a lot today. But anyway, if you enjoyed the episode, make sure you leave a like, you leave a comment, and you subscribe, and you stop by, make sure you stop by around 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. for a Night in the Woods run, Night in the Woods game, playthrough part, and the daily for this day, you know, respectively. And thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.